Is this place functioning as a cool down place? It seems that way. I was just looking at some videos on YouTube, which I usually do not do these days. And I came away from it just saying, you know what? I gotta cool down. I mean, this stuff is just, my gosh, people are going nuts. Too much. So here, it's quieter, it's calmer. We're not zapping a whole bunch of information at you and all that kind of stuff. And maybe the function of this place is to help people cool down. I hope so. And maybe it'll become even more that way in the future, because even sites with these very good videos, actually, but it's just peppering you with this emotional stuff. It doesn't really tell you what you need to know. We don't have to bring in everything here. We don't have to bring all this stuff in. We can just relax, cool down. What we need to know is completely simple. So there's no need to try to do too much. We don't bring all, I mean, the world of the movies, the world of music videos, all these things. No. I don't watch any of that stuff. Just keep the simple vision. And it's going to be necessary. There's some heavy construction. It's what is this? Almost 11 p.m. There's some heavy construction going on in the distance. It's pretty amazing. Maybe it's Caltrans working on the freeway or something like that. I don't know. A little odd. So ISON is coming in, and you know, all of the symbology of Revelation is just da 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 da. But meanwhile, there is a simpler way to look at the entire situation. And don't forget to be quiet, to be calm, to be unconcerned. It's not about who has the most information. It's about who gets into this, let's call it the neutral state, the third state. It's the stalemate state, really, but we can call it state of neutrality. I've always been told that I'm supposed to be like a Swiss. What is a Swiss? I'm a Swiss person. I've always told, yeah, you're the Swiss guy. What is that? Neutrality. But this is completely profound, actually, because everything that is trying to reach a goal in existence cannot stand the state of neutrality. They have to flee. So if we can get into this state of neutrality, the perfect no, the perfect stalemate, no to any progress towards a goal. The goal of existence is to try and teach spirit how to die. So we don't need that progress because it's futile. We can get into a neutral state. Then everything that flees from that neutral state is part of the ego, actually. It's almost like when we can get into that neutral state, all of the complexes, everything will just flee away from us. This is the real deep teachings. And we don't need the other stuff around it, actually. It's not necessary. But I know it's out there. It's just overload. It is overload in the world right now. And the neutral state is what we want to get into. The third state. And so it's not really the kind of attainment that we're used to thinking about. Because the attainment we're used to thinking about is getting somewhere, doing something, achieving something. The neutral state is like the perfect now, the holy instant. In an instant, nothing is happening. there's no time for anything to happen. So you might say the holy instant is the neutral state. We can get into that state. Now, what I discovered today was that the ego tries to bluff this state. And this is the whole problem, why we're not in this state. Because the ego says, someday I'm going to get you, because I'm going to figure out how to reconcile mutual exclusives and combine them. And that is going to give me the power to break your state of neutrality, which is really being presented by the Holy Spirit. This is a lie. This is a bluff by the ego, but it's what gets us, because we start thinking, I better at least do something to prevent this. If you can simply have the faith to abide in the state of neutrality, knowing that the ego's this bluff is completely invalid. And this is something that I know because I've experienced this mutual exclusive condition and seen, can it be abided in? And I found out, no, it cannot. The ego cannot abide in it. It's impossible. It will never happen. So there isn't any power or capability to break up this neutral state. There isn't any. So we don't have to leave it and accomplish something. This is the secret. And I just saw that today, and it really lightened my load. And so it's this kind of insight that just is so outside the box of the other stuff that I'm hearing. It just makes the whole thing so much simpler, actually. The ego's bluffing. We're not in the neutral state, which the neutral state is for the purpose of solving the continuity issue that we have, reminding us of reality, of knowing, and therefore we can drop perception, which is seeing. It's not knowing. But we have to stay in the neutral state in order to get the benefit from it. We can't just get a glimpse of it. That's not enough. That helps us move towards it, but you have to abide in it. Abide in the state. Why do we not abide in the state? Because the ego threatens us and intimidates us and bluffs us and says, it has a way. It's going to eventually get us. And then we feel insecure. We say, well, I better first fix this problem, defend against this possibility, and then I can abide in this state. That is the whole problem. I spent my lifetime trying to fix this problem, and how do you, protect yourself from mutual exclusives? And I've been trying to figure it out, modeling it for myself, and say, okay, the ego is lying. Cannot embrace mutual exclusives. Together. Cannot bring them together. When you try to bring truth and lies together, what happens? Lies disappear. When you try to bring light and darkness together, darkness disappears. When you try to bring perfect neutrality and non-neutrality together, what happens? Question, right? Neutrality reigns. Okay. That there is no mixing of no exception and exception, right? There's no mixing of that. You can't mix endlessness and time. Either one's true and the other's not. And endlessness is beyond time. It goes beyond time. You can't have both being absolute truth together. They're not on the same level at all. You cannot put truth and lies together as one. It's not possible. But the ego insists that it's going to do it. And I say, well, we just have to say, assure you, knock yourself out. And not get frightened by that bluff. So what the world really needs is a cool down. It is. People are getting freaked out. I mean, I read all the comments, you can tell their minds are like, oh my God, wow. Like this, it's just. They have to cool down. People have to cool down. you salvation is to have the continuity problem solved. It's that's solved by abiding in this state, the perfect no, the perfect neutrality condition, and the feeling is one of steady bliss. But you have to abide in it. You can't get the state glimpse and then talk, symbolize, you know, go all over the place. That doesn't work. That's not abidance. That is defensiveness, worried about the ego, what the ego might do eventually. Might do eventually. It will never do it. So I just hadn't connected these dots yet. You know, it's just like, wow. Now, it is, the times are super intense. I mean, as far as the symbology, yeah, it's all there. It's all there. All the symbology is there. But we don't have to be obsessed about it, actually. I'm not worried about it. I went to bed last night about midnight and woke up at 2:30 a.m. 2.5 hours of sleep, man. Couldn't get back to sleep. That's how my days are going now. Just ridiculous. Very tough and intense. And people close to me are suffering horribly, actually. And I wish I could do something for them. But what I can do is cool down. What I'm best at, what I'm skilled at, my gift is to escape the world, actually. That is my gift. People say, what are you going to do to help the world? And I say, that's a hard one to answer, because my gift is to escape the world. Escape existence. Escape this training program of existence by abiding in this blissful condition of neutrality, and thereby being reminded of reality, and thereby finally having perception, relinquishing perception altogether. But that again is beyond the scope of what we can even focus on. So, special gift, escaping existence. What do you bring to existence? Ah, the escape from existence. What I find also in these videos is a lack of humor. Everybody's so serious. What I find when I focus on this, it's humorous to me. It brings a smile to my face. I don't know why. But I remember Jesus telling me in A Course in Miracles, he says, what happened was this tiny mad idea arose, a whim, and you forgot to laugh. You forgot to laugh at it. And he says, he says, one day you will laugh at it. That's all. And then after you laugh, it's no more. And so I find it very important when you talk about this, it's funny. It's really funny in some spiritual way. It's not funny like in the kind of jokes that we tell, and the suffering is not funny, but there's some other level of ridiculousness about it that is, and our spirit laughs at it, really. If you want to know how does our spirit feel, really feel, it laughs at all this nonsense. It's hilarious. It's just completely ridiculous. And I mean, we're, you know, very, very serious. You gotta, the ones that are liberated and abiding in bliss, they're shining and the humor and is just, you know, radiating, and they're so, they can laugh, and they're so blissful and happy and overflowing with this kind of blissful mirth and lightheartedness, even in the face of all this stuff. And they can talk about this intense stuff, and yet the bliss never leaves them. The bliss of neutrality. They're not worried about the ego. The threats of the ego anymore. So, at some point, people Really, you may need to cool down. Absolutely cool down. So these videos are a little bit longer. Give people a chance to cool down. They need to decompress. It's like coming up from deep in the ocean, coming up like a diver. They need to decompress, so they stop for a little while, and they go up a little further, stop for a while, rise up a little more, stop for a while, so they don't get the bends. So we don't want to just do these short little videos, da 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 da, boom, okay. No, longer, or you calm down, start to breathe, start to laugh, start to recover your humor about the situation, about the world. It's a funny thing. I believe that all the misery I've gone through in my life is actually, I imposed it upon myself just to try to appear normal to people. Otherwise, I would have just been laughing all the time. And people said, "What are you laughing about?" Spirit is laughs at this ridiculousness of the ego. It's boastfulness. It's boasts are silly, very funny. The clit, the more you see him, the funnier it gets. Okay. And if you don't see it, it's not so funny. It's not funny at all, as a matter of fact. I didn't used to laugh at all. But I don't really laugh in public, really, no. So I sort of like impose this death-like state on myself, just so I appear to be normal. Ooh, otherwise people say, "Oh, you know, what's the matter with you?" But I have to really impose a severe death grip on myself so that I don't, you know, don't appear to be blissful. It's very difficult to try to appear, you know, normal, death-like. I have to really, really suffer terrible. And you may be doing this too. You may look at your suffering. Why am I suffering? And maybe it's because inside you're not suffering. And you say, "Oh, I don't want anybody to think I'm not suffering here." You know, I mean, how would that be? So you say, I better find some way to really, really, really put myself through the ringer, you know. And the closer we get to the neutral state, accepting it, the more we beat ourselves up and cause severe suffering, even like suicidal, you know, push ourselves into the brink of suicide because we're almost ready to accept bliss, and they say, "Oh my gosh, I hope nobody sees this, and I gotta get really real suicidal," and but then if you can see that's what you're doing, oh, lightens up just like that. You say, "Ah, okay, I see what I'm doing." I have to pretend even more severely that I'm really with this death training program. I saw everybody say, "Look, everybody, yeah, I'm ready to die right now. I'm suicidal, and I just feel horrible. I feel so terrible. I'm really with this program, you know." But really, within, you say, "I'm ready to drop this program entirely." And you just make sure you put on pretense. Your pretense has to become very strong, very, very strong. So just give that a consideration, that may be what we're doing. Those who are going towards dropping this program may be, you know, just stifling themselves actually. And if you see it, you'll have a chuckle at it. Yeah. It's okay, I have to keep doing that, huh? But so my job is to say, "Hey, maybe we don't have to keep doing that. We can call the ego's bluff." Somebody has to call the ego's bluff. I'm trying to, that is for sure. There have been those who in this neutral state for sure, like Ramana Maharshi, Nanda Maima, and others, okay? I only mention those because we had pictures and videos and many, many witnesses. I mean, there's a poster on YouTube who was in the company of Ananda Maima a lot. And she has told us what it's like, and I was just like, wow, amazing. You know, they're living people in this world who were hanging out with her and just in the house and satsang, and they just said it was just absolutely incredible, just incomprehensible. So some people probably that were with Ramon, I don't know any personally. They'd have to be 63, you know, and probably in their 70s. So I'm sure there are some in the world, yeah. And so that they were in the neutral state, absolutely, just abiding in the neutral state. So it's certainly possible here. It's certainly possible. And they definitely help cool things down. Definitely. The cooling down effect was amazing. I've told the story of the Kumbh Mela in, it might have been Allahabad, but one of the big ones, and Nana Maima was there, and the various orders, the sannyasi orders, what do they call them? The yogi ascetics, and they were having a big argument, as they often do, about who's ranked higher and lower lands and all this money and things, and you know, mammon, you know, there was some severe problems. She invited all the heads of all these orders into her big tent there, and they just all sat down and satsang, relaxed, darshan, and after a while they had no idea what they were arguing about. They didn't even remember that they were arguing there. You know, they were one in spirit again. Simply, they cooled down. Just by just sitting there. Just the whole attitude, the permeated, you know, this is what we need. We don't really need somebody so much that is da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- We need someone who can, you know, cool us down so we can think actually more clearly, connect the dots, realize the ego's only bluffing, realize we can't get into this neutral state, and that solves our problem for us, actually. Because we begin, this enables us to remember reality. It's similar enough. It's how to use perception to remind yourself of reality, and that solves a continuity problem, and then you don't have any other problem. Because again, if not for the continuity problem, we would drop all of this training program instantly. Gone. Not even a trace of memory that any of this ever happened. Not a trace. So, really, our only problem is this continuity problem. And so we abide in this neutral state and gradually let this dissipate. The third state. Maybe third state, third eye, 33. There you go. Little symbology, but I don't know if that's got anything to do with anything. Just abide in that state. That is what our aim is. Abide in that state. So when those who are abiding in the state, they cool everybody down. And when we're cooled down, humor returns. Sense of spirit returns. And it seems like the sense of spirit is like evaporated from this world in a lot of ways. Boy, I sure haven't felt it in the longest time. I was driving along a freeway recently, and for some reason I was really tired, and I suddenly felt how I felt like when I was young, and the sense of spirit, you know, was there. I just said, oh my gosh, I haven't felt that in, you know, 40 years or something. It's been so long. We just don't feel it. The times are too intense, actually. Again, those who are talking about all the events and stuff, it's pretty accurate. Some people are very, very amazingly accurate. And a lot of people have their finger on the pulse. And it is all going down for sure. But what's the remedy? The remedy is to abide in this neutral state. That's the remedy. And within this neutral state, abiding within this, miracles can happen. Relocation can happen. All sorts of stuff can happen, that is true. But the essential thing is to abide in this, and abide in bliss, actually. And as long as that ego has that leverage over you, you can't do it. What we're doing is we're taking away the ego's leverage. And his great bluff says that one day it's going to combine mutual exclusives. That's a lie. It's a nothing but a bluff, and when anyone can finally accept that, then they're going to abide in the neutral state, which is the perfect no of the Holy Spirit, the perfect no saying, no, we can't ever die. No, we can't. No, we cannot combine mutual exclusives. No, we can't. It's the Holy Spirit knows perfectly that it's impossible. Whereas the ego says, yes, we can, eventually we'll find a way. We'll get enough supercomputers working on it. And, you know, the ego's bluffing us, saying, we got all these supercomputers. How can you possibly say we can never accomplish it? For sure, we're going to get it. And you just have to laugh at that. Don't forget to laugh at the ego's preposterousness. And a lot of people I know are hurting out there, for sure. The people in my family, there's just very bad suffering going on right now. A lot of people, and they're just, I know, of course. It's not a joke, although at some level, this is all a joke. So no matter how bad you're suffering, you try to see maybe a little chuckle, something just about it, just say, there's something funny about all this, you know, really funny about it. Yeah, there's a bunch of funny business going on, actually, in existence. It's nothing but monkey business, actually. Nothing but that monkey business. Certainly, the suffering, I'm suffering severely, actually. Putting this pretense on, you know, it's not sleeping, and it's just, I mean, I'm just going hour by hour, day by day. It's a very brutish time right now. But on the other hand, no room for excuses. We have to get the job done and call the ego's bluff, fight in the third state, perfect neutrality, no triumph, no victory, no winning, no losing. No winners, no losers. We don't need winners and losers. What does reality? What can reality win over? You see, that's the question, right? Is there something other than reality? Reality needs to win against, prevail against? No, not at all. Is there something that needs to lose for reality to be real? No. So this perfect neutrality is very much close to, you know, it helps remembrance of reality. So don't get caught up in the franticness of the world, the frantic pace. Spend some time. Look at your garden. Don't be rushing. Don't be rushing around. Don't be hustling and bustling. You don't have to know anything except dwell, abide in the neutral state. That's all that needs to be done. That's not a state of knowing all these facts and who's winning and who's losing. It doesn't matter. Another thing, that's why if you go into this neutral condition, state of mind, and it doesn't matter what's happening in the world. It doesn't matter because you're neutral about it. See, you could come back a million years from now. It does the same as now. It doesn't matter. Because you'd be neutral about everything. You're still completely neutral. You're not trying to assess winners and losers. It's a state of non-judgment, actually, to tell you the truth. This neutrality is a state of non-judgment. Perfect non-judgment, actually. So it doesn't matter what's happening. You know, we're all afraid to get into the state because we'll miss something. We won't know what has happened in the world. What happened? But it doesn't matter. In the state of neutrality, we're not trying to, you know, we're not looking at who's winning, who's losing, what's going on, what's progress is being made, changes, all that stuff. We're neutral in all of that. Neutral. Perfect neutrality. Fabulous, fabulous condition. Awesome condition. So, October's the month. It's a blessed month. It's the month of opportunity. It's the harvest month. And this is when the final harvest takes place, October, right? The farmers, they get everything in before the heavy frost comes. So this is the blessed month. This is when we connect the dots and we enter into a state of perfect neutrality. This helps cool down other people. Everyone starts cooling down. They say, hey, my clarity is starting to return. Oh yeah, wow. And get out of this franticness. We're not trying to defeat anything. Not trying to win against anything. No winning, no losing. Just this beautiful, blissful state of neutrality. All right, let's see what happens. Let's see if I can get some sleep tonight. I've had like one night of sleep in the last month or so. Actually, I think I slept through the night. It's just ridiculous. But I end up taking naps. I have to take a nap, you know, in 6 o'clock or whenever. I just have to somehow survive it. You know, it's not easy. But what can we do? We have to keep a sense of humor and just do the best we can. All right. Very great. That's it for this one.